Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to talk about how to replace the FFC cable for Epson ET-8550. If you have a burned main board, you're probably going to get a burned FFC cable and a printhead. So today we're going to focus on how to replace the FFC cable. Here's Abby.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I'll be showing in this video and explaining how to take out the FFC cables to this Epson 8550 printer. I'm taking off the two side panels first, and we're already on the second side panel, so there's going to be three screws, one on the top in the back and one on the base at the bottom in the back. Then you can go ahead and lift up the scanner and then lift up that gray cover, and on the very far blue tab you can lift that up and there will be a screw in there. Unscrew that and then give a big old tug and push backwards, and that should undo this side cover here, the side panel. Now we need to work on this front panel that you have. Go to the side where the main board is and disconnect the white cable, the white, black and gray cable, and the two FFC cables. Give that front panel a little wiggle to make sure that it's disconnected. Then turn your printer around to the other side, and where that gray box is, there's gonna be that metal gray box, there's gonna be a screw. Unscrew that, and then looking down on top of the printer, you're gonna want to take out the two screws holding down that front panel. Flip your printer on its back, and looking from the bottom, you're gonna see a tab that sits under where all the ink is, all the ink area. And you're gonna push in that tab and then pry off the front panel like this. All right, so now we're gonna work on accessing the FFC cables. We're looking down on top of the printer here, and we want to get this black plastic cover off so we can see the FFC cables under it. We're gonna take off these screws that we see. So I see three of them openly visible, but there is a little hidden trap door here, is what I nicknamed it, right there. And there is a screw under there, so unscrew that. And now you should have access to be able to lift this black piece off. And we should be able to now see our FFC cables. Voila! All right, so to stay on top of everything, I went ahead and I labeled my FFC cables. So I put an L for left, but then I wanted to get even more meticulous in it, and I put LT for left top, and then even more, I put LB for left bottom. That way when I try to replace my cables again, I know how to put them back in. So again, right top and right bottom. That way, when I put them back in, I know how to do it. So here's the part where it's not really difficult if you just take your time and be patient. The FFC cables have double-sided tape with them, and to get it through this hole, you'll see that the large FFC cables have this like dividing line down the middle where they crease. So if you just follow that crease and you fold it in half, it should come out very easy through this hole right there. Like I folded it in half and now I can just slide it out, but you can't do it if I didn't fold it. So again, just follow that line of the fold and fold it and then pull it through, and simple like that. But again, just follow along, you'll see there's some double-sided tape there. And now here's the part where, like I said, it can get a little tricky, but if you just take your time and be patient and think it through. So there's some plastic piece that goes with the FFC cable to help it not get tangled up when the CR goes back and forth. So this plastic piece is also holding this third FFC cable that I believe is going connecting to the CSIC board. So you don't want to pull that third smaller FFC cable out. You want to just pull these two main ones that we labeled top left. We want to pull the ones out that we labeled. So again, it's just focusing on making sure that there's no double-sided tape connected to anything. All right, and so now that we've gotten to the front of the printer where it is, you'll see that I'm trying to like pull it off of something, that plastic piece that's holding the FFC cables is also now being held by like a clip. So the printers, they make this holding a clip area. And so now it was easier for me to move the printhead area over. And so now this clip here, instead of it all going upwards, that one went down. So I showed with my finger how that clip went down. So it was easier for me to grab the FFC cables and just move downward to go under the clip. This one kind of goes over. They usually do a back and forth pattern of a upward clip, downward clip, just so the cables can have a weaving in and out pattern so they don't get loose and get caught up when printing something. So it's really just trying to take these larger FFC cables out of this pattern. Again, like I said, not the hardest thing to do, but like you can see there's some double-sided tape there that I had to try to pull apart. But then also I'm trying to line up that smaller FFC cable back in a bit with the clips just so I don't lose too much of my, I'll call it like a trail back into where I need to put these FFC cables when I get replacements, because this is a customer repair and these FFC cables were burned. Again, so labeling everything as we go. This is the bottom of the FFC cables where they go into the main board. So I'm just labeling them 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm labeling that last small one 5. And that number 5 one's not coming out. But later on, again, when I replace these, I'll know which side they were facing, which way they go, and it'll be easy to replace them. So again, it might seem simple that you'll remember it. Either you can take a picture, but writing it down is just really helpful. It's a quick step that doesn't take long to do. So then again, I'm just pulling these out, and you'll see now we have our whole FFC cable bundle out, and we can find a new one to replace it with, and you just follow your steps backwards. All right, everybody, happy printing. I hope this was helpful. Bye.
Okay, if this is helpful for you, please subscribe to our channel or visit us at www.bchtechnology.com. You can also visit us locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Don't be shy. You can come in for printer repair, ask us a question, or bare knuckle fighting with us. If you can win both of us, we're going to give you a free printer repair. You only pay for the parts. Okay, happy printing. Cheers.